So this is something basically full sourcing project is like helping that to like customer. So let's take one quick example just to understand this full sourcing project. Or this full sourcing project is also called as a multi-stage sourcing as well. So let me just move to the notepad. Just a moment. Okay. So this is also called as a multi-stage sourcing. Okay. So now let's try to understand what is multi-stage sourcing. So to understand this multi-stage sourcing, let me give you one quick example. So let's assume from our customer side that we are planning to buy a office laptop, and for the to buy the office laptop, we are planning to invite around 100 of supplier. So since even we have the information about our product, but we do not have that much information about the supplier. And before starting that bidding activity, we would like to collect some more information about the supplier. So since we want to include only that information of the supplier, so in that case, what we'll do, we can create with the RFI. So let's assume that we have created that RFI, and in that RFI that we have invited 100 of supplier by asking them list of questionnaire, just to only collect about the information. So that information in terms of the like some delivery time, that information in terms about the customer support service, so whatever that we required from the like customer side, they have included like with the help of the questionnaire. So let's say that we have some criteria that we are looking a supplier who can provide like 24/7 service, and we will buy that our laptop from that company, from that supplier itself, at least who have that customer rating 4-star. Just for an example, so let's say out of 100, that around 80 supplier that you find out that 80 suppliers are there who have the customer rating 4-star, and they are also supporting 24/7 customer support. Okay, so in that case, if you see, so out of 100, that 80 suppliers are in your scope, and 20 suppliers are not in our scope, because they are not provide their customer rating is less than the 3, and even they are not offering 24/7 support. So in that case, like if we'll proceed further, so we'll not invite the 20 supplier, and we have to only invite the 80 supplier, because the 20 supplier is not in our scope, right? So let's say that we are planning to create the RFP. In that case, so what we'll do, we'll invite that with only 80 supplier, right? So after completion of this RFP event, so while analyzing that, we find out that out of 80 in during RFP event, that out of 80, that around 20 suppliers are there who have submitted the same price and same term and condition. So that means like still that we have the 20 supplier with the same price, with the same term and conditions, and restricted supplier is also out of scope. So why they are out of scope now again? Because they have submitted, given some higher price as compared to other supplier, and their term and conditions are also not flexible as it is giving by the restricted supplier. So in that case, still we have questions like which supplier that we have to select. So here we can say like 20 suppliers with same price, right? So if among these 20 supplier, if you have to select a particular supplier for the purchasing, so still we are not clear, and still we are on the same page as we were earlier, because the 20 supplier has given the same price. So what do you think that what we have to do in the next? So in the next, that customer, they have the other choice. So what customer can do, if customer would like to go again with the RFP event, they can again create this RFP event with only 2 supplier. RFP with only 20 supplier. Okay, so other customer can create this like RFP event again, and they can only invite this 20 supplier, and they can ask them, like they can provide some like comment or some other information. Like earlier, they have like received the quotation from them, but that quotation price was not that as per expected. And even that other supplier also, they have like given, they have provided the same quotation. So kindly try to provide that best quotation so that we can select you for to our business. So that's something they can provide the information and they can again create the RFP. So this is one option. Second option is that what customer can do, customer can like create the auctions instead of the RFP. So Ariba is also offering like auction that is called basically a reverse auction. So what they can do, they can create this reverse auction with 20 suppliers. It's up to the customer choice. So if customer they want to go RFP, they can go. If customer they wants to go with the reverse auction, that is auctions, they can go with the auction. So it's, there's no like a thumb rule, either the customer they have to go with the RFP or the customer they have to go with the reverse auction. That's up to the customer decision. So some of the customer, they would like to go with again RFP, like only 20 supplier. And some of the customer, they think like, why unnecessary we have to go with the RFP? Why we cannot go with the auction? Because if they will create the auction, so in that case, they will create some competitive environment like between those suppliers. So chances are there, like in the auction, they will get the better price. So that's something depends on the customer like requirement, customer like that customer need or customer requirement. So basically this is called as a multi-stage sourcing. So that means here, like whatever the event, how many times we would like to create from the customer side, we can create. There is no restriction to the customer. So this is called as the multi-stage sourcing. Any questions here?
What if the price is different? Will at that time, it will be multi-source also now?
Okay, let me tell you a little bit detail. So let's say we would like to buy the laptop, 100 quantity, and our price is that, let's say 100 USD. This is our expectation that we have decided like this, whoever supplier will give this price like 100 USD, will buy the 100 quantity from that supplier. Okay, so in the RFP only, in the RFP event, we have to only receive this quotation, but collect the information and we have some criteria like that better customer, like the 24/7 customer service and the supplier should have the rating four star. That's something. So based upon the criteria, we have only like we have created this RFI, and in the RFI, we have invited the 100 supplier. So let's assume that we have the 100 supplier and we have invited the 100 supplier. And like during this RFI analysis, we find out that out of 100, only 80 supplier, they have like, they are providing like a 24/7 customer services and they have the customer rating more than 4-star as well. So that means now we have the 80 supplier. So now what we'll do during an RFP event, so in the RFP event, we will only invite the 80 supplier. So in the 80 supplier, we have to include this price. Okay, so whatever supplier, they will provide you this, like this price, that's something we have to select. This price, we have to like consider as a criteria during this any event. Either you are going with this RFP or we are going with this again RFP or this auctions. And this was your question?
Yes.